Nick, you and I have waited all year for this. It's the most exciting, action-packed 2 weeks in all of sports, and it tips off in today's game between the Delaware Fighting Blue Hens and the Villanova Wildcats.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Wildcats, by all accounts, should have an easy time of it tonight, Dick Vitale. How do they ensure that victory, though?
They should listen to me and follow the simple keys, baby. First, work the ball to the interior to your post players. Let them be your option number one offensively. Secondly, be monsters on the boards. Don't be afraid to get tangled up. Crash the glass. And lastly, be aggressive defensively. Don't give them any open looks.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action. See what's in store for us. From the top of the circle, he misses the trifecta. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Nicky's working on that low block on that right hip.
I tell you what,
draws the foul and gets the basket.
He's into it. Win, baby, that's his name. I like that in a player.
The Blue Hens are going to be at the line for the first time in this game. Good. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. He fakes the shot. Fakes the shot. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Fed the low block. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Tries for two. I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Shows patience waiting for the reset.
Look at that spacing.
The power forward handles the feed with the fake. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket. Not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Inside. Entry pass in the paint. Jumps in. He puts it in with contact and all.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, how about this crowd? They're enjoying this close matchup, and there's nothing better than a close game during tournament time.
Thanks, Aaron. Trying to pack it inside. Goes up for two. They still don't score. He keeps the dribble as they reset. Number 10 handles the pass. That's a foul. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
Here's a flash from the high post.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
He tries the three ball. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. For two, and in and out. Gordon receives the ball. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open with a rejection. And the ball goes out of bounds. The ball goes out of bounds. Oh, and the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
He'll regroup the offense. Looking for a good shot. The fake. He shoots from the baseline. Got it. circle, they work it around the perimeter. Doesn't go. Inside, the power forward receives the pass. He lets it go. Off the rim and no good. Moving it around the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the key. That was nice. Opportunity for 2-for-1. Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Here's the three ball. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
Well, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
For the bucket. Can't get the shot to go. The Wildcats have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
The ball goes out of play.
These teams are looking at the second half to decide the outcome of this ball game.
Well, Dick, so far we've got a close one. Any play that sticks out to you as the highlight of the half?
My highlight of the first half has to be this trifecta, Brad. It showed another one of the deadly weapons that this team has offensively. I expect more of that in the second half.
Let's get back down to the action where it looks like the two teams are all set to start the second half. Villanova is known for their accurate field goal shooting, though it was anything but that in the first half.
Hey, perhaps the whole team caught the cold shooting bug. They'd better find a cure right away at halftime, or it's going to be a long, long night.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Takes it off him. Here they go into transition. The shot from the baseline. Buried it. Entry pass in the paint. Here he is defensively, and this is going to be an Academy Award, Dick.
Absolutely, Academy Award at its best.
Dickie's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. With the jump hook. He's taking a lot of bad shots out there, Dick.
I know, he's trying to catch fire, Brad, but it's just not there.
Rejects it. The shooting guard gets the pass. There was no doubt about that one.
Let's go to the instant replay camera. Up and inside.
He shoots from long range. Way off target. Gave it up. And he'll kick it back outside. Number 15 is fired up and ready to go.
I love seeing players play with emotion and passion. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
There's a double team waiting there. Try to come up with a steal, and they do. Looking for a good shot. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
He goes to the line, shooting two. First shot, good. Second one, good. Tries for two, perfectly executed. The Wildcats have been receiving that additional attention due to their recent success.
That's why it's so important to make it to the tournament. Once you get there, you then know what it takes to get back there.
Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
For two. And he missed. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, a sense of urgency down here on the bench. The coaching staff is starting to sense their players are starting to panic, and they want that stop before any further damage is done. Guys?
Can we expect a little change in direction here, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if the schemes change somewhat.
And, Dick, that puts the lead at 9.
9 points is surmountable. This is the time to start jacking threes.
He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that.
Cross court. The shooting guard takes the feed. Off the lazy pass. He launches the bomb. He's good for another score.
Hands in his face. Anytime now, boys.
Count that as a personal foul. You talk about a great drive. How about the State Farm drive of the game?
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up, up, and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special.
Defense got it after knocking it loose. For the deuce. Dick, if you ask me, they're not getting a whole lot of open looks tonight.
They're not moving the ball the way they were taught, Brad.
The shooting guard with the ball.
They need a basket here to turn this into a two-possession game.
The shooting guard gets the ball. He launches a three. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Well, this is a one-man show, Brad. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
Here's a double team. I got to be sure they'll continue to look to foul here, Dick. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock. Possession or timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
Points off turnovers, Dick, a stat I know coaches pay a lot of attention to.
Hey, Brad, it sure is. You want to limit your opponent's number of points off turnovers. Ultimately, you want to nullify the easy basket.
Shot clock is dead. Oh, and look at the crowd and look at the reaction.
I think the home fans are going crazy. There's jubilation.
He'll have one and the bonus. Got it. Second shot is good.
They really need a score here to turn this into a one possession game.
Timeout's been called. Let's check in with Aaron.
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious, and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
Aaron's right about that. It'll be interesting to see the level of energy, Dick, when they come out of this timeout.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle.
And the shot blocks. And the ball goes out of play. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
On the outside. Kicks it out. Well, Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going up.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, and you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Fighting Blue Hens came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team, because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during a regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well, as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
Brad Nessler saying so long. For my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, thanks for joining us.